We are speaking with Olympic gold medalist, the coach, Julius Naranjo. Thanks for joining us, Julius. And along with him, his fiancée. She's really the big star of this whole thing. It's the gold medalist from the Philippines, the first ever, Hidilyn Diaz. For us, at least in the Philippines and on Guam, the biggest story of the Olympic Games, the first ever making history last July in Tokyo, Hidilyn winning the weightlifting gold medal at 30 years old in the 55K, you know, to translate that, that's 120 pounds, right? So getting the Olympic record at 127 kilos, that's 280 pound clean and jerk. Hidilyn, has that soaking in?
I still did not expect I was able to do it. By God's grace and with the team HD and Julius that has the, you know, the knowledge to make me strong to prepare for Olympics is really, I think that's a good thing.
Julius, you're mentioning that you've done hundreds of interviews since. How can you describe the ride since then?
After the Olympics, we won't be busy, but it turns out that we were much, much more busier than this whole preparation for the Olympics. But the good thing about it is was we were able to share our story. We were able to hopefully inspire people. And I think that's where it now stands for us, because to represent what we did in the Olympics, it's just something that we didn't expect, but we're here now and we're living our life, trying to do our best.
You know, for the Guam fans, you know, the connection here obviously is Julius being a FD graduate class of 2009, being a big part of the Guam Weightlifting Federation. Julius, I wanted to ask you, every contribution to a successful team, this in particular Team HD, what variables of Guam did you contribute to the success and leading up to this achievement?
Growing up in Guam, when we move to like a big city like Manila, or when we travel outside, it's such a different feeling, because you know, when you're at home, you're in paradise. You know, I took this value of being a hard worker and just wanting to experience life. I took that with me and continuing to be that good person and be a really nice person. It stuck with me all throughout. I think those are some of the things that I brought with me.
Take us back to Turkmenistan, 2017. I mean, did you guys, when you first met at that competition, expect that you would get to where you're at today?
No, I did not expect that he will coach me. I did not expect that he will move here from Guam to Philippines. And I think it's a God's blessing. At first, I'm like, why you will move here? You have a beautiful life in Guam, then you move here. But I guess that's his purpose. Going here is to help me achieve the first gold medal for the Philippines.
You know, leaving Guam and taking this big step. I mean, to be honest, like, I loved what I was doing back home before I left. I loved what I was doing. I was filmmaking, I was coaching, I was training with my team. But you know, sometimes you'll have some unforeseen circumstances that made me wonder, like, you know, I want to achieve more, you know, and she's my partner and it's a long distance relationship and stuff like that. And, you know, I realized that she'll be focused on Tokyo and the Olympics and she won't have time. But then I realized there was an opening and there was a time when her strength and conditioning coach had to leave. And I realized that if I were to leave Guam, you know, I'm starting from zero. I had a full-time job. I realized that I'd have to give that up. There'll be times where I'll be struggling financially, but I realized that this is the sacrifices we make if we want to achieve something great. You know, all my life, I've worked hard, I've hustled, and I want to have a nice story to tell my kids someday.
Is it worth it?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I think now I look it back at it.
That's a great question.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's worth it. I think it's worth it because we were able to achieve something great. You know, when you're from a small island, you know, you want to achieve big things. And this, you know, this is something that I'm proud to be a part of. But, you know, my journey has started over again. So we have more to achieve now with Paris.
Heidi, you've been to Guam twice. Julius brought you over twice. What do you think of the island?
Yeah, at first, I just lived in their place. He's so busy working. Then on the second time, but in the first time, he turned me around in Guam. Of course, I love it. I love it. Like, I go to the Tumon and the beach. Then the luxury mall. And the people, yeah. I like the people there. And I was able to train. I think that's the most important thing. Even though I'm in vacation, but I was able to train, and that's a good thing.
Julius, you made the big proposal last fall. We saw the video online. Heidi accepted the proposal. When's the big date? Have you guys set that up yet?
Since our schedule's been quite busy, we haven't even had time to plan, but we're hoping sometime this year, hopefully around mid this year. But with the way with our schedule and everything, it's gonna be a lot to squeeze in, but hopefully around maybe June or July, we don't know yet. But
so let me give you your first newlywed game questionnaires. Are you guys ready?
Okay, sure.
Julius and Heidi, who said I love you first?
Yeah, it's okay. You.
Where?
Oh, yeah, it's her. It's usually her.
Who spends more time in the shower?
No, it's you.
It's you. Remember? Like 2 hours?
Oh, yeah.
2 hours. How many dates before your first kiss?
I don't remember.
Yeah.
A few. Maybe 3 or 4.
Who spends the most money?
I'm correct, but
yeah, she's like tight with money, but the Japanese in me is like always Japanese. You know, if you purchase something, you want to get the best of the best. In Guam, we're so used to getting the American products, you know, so it's like sometimes I have to order things, you know, online or something. The brands that I'm used to, I'm not used to the Asian brands or the international brands, so sometimes I gotta get the American brands, you know, the US brands.
So, yeah,
that's a lot.
It's a lot more expensive.
All right, who's more disciplined?
Me. Yeah, me.
I think we're even on that.
No, it's me.
Yeah, actually,
I can find the food. I sleep early.
Yeah, I'll just give her that.
Yeah.
Who's the better cook?
Oh, I'm the better cook, of course.
Okay. I'm the best good eater. And completely.
Yeah, we're from Guam, so you know.
He's really good.
If you could treat the other to anything, what would it be?
I just want a simple life. So I just want you to ask to eat in a beautiful scenario or in a beautiful
so view. You'll treat me to a beautiful view.
Yeah, then we eat steak. But you're the one who will cook.
So that's not really a treat. Because I'm the one that's treating you. Okay, I think for me, I want to treat you to take you to Guam, Saipan, Timiya.
Oh, yeah. I forget. I want to ask the two of us go to Europe and travel there.
So you'll treat me to go to Europe?
Yeah, but you treat me go to Guam with this island.
The Marianas.
Okay. Hey, you know, Heidi, you know, you've gone through 4 Olympics. You've reached the top of the mountain, right? What's left for you to do from a personal standpoint, from a competitive standpoint? I know you've mentioned you're looking at 2024. And from even a social standpoint, what's left that you can set your goals for?
I think I want to do it because I love weightlifting. But not because like people like saying that I have to stop, but because it's also for my mental health. I cannot just stop weightlifting because I win. I think when I reach my point already that I would say I cannot do it already or I have other things to do. But you know, weightlifting is I've been a weightlifter since 2002, and it's really hard for me to just let go after a win. I want to influence more people. That's why I'm still doing this. I'm still like, I also want to build more like champion with him, together with him. And that's why we're still here.
Finally, did you want to say anything, give a message to any of your fans here on Guam and Tagalog?
Sa lahat po ng mga Pilipino na nandyan sa Guam, thank you so much po sa suporta. And patuloy po tayong suportahan ang mga atletang Pilipino. At si Julius ay taga dyan po. Gusto ko lang po sabihin maganda po ang Guam at na-enjoy ko pong pumunta dyan sa Guam. So see you soon po kung makapunta po kami dyan.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Philippines' first ever Olympic gold medalist here on GSPN. Hidilyn Diaz, thank you for joining us. And Guam's own Julius Naranjo, thank you for taking some time out. Man, we've been looking forward to this conversation. Appreciate it deeply, and good luck for the rest of your competitions, the next Olympics, and your upcoming marriage. So we will continue to support you guys from here on Guam. Thanks again for joining us.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us.